not emotional distancing.
Right. COVID, we are going through the second round of what it could cause to our personal life. For the first time ever, we are seeing to keep ourselves distanced from our closest one. We thought everything is okay. We even started calling for in-person meetings, even in Meraki. But the last 1 week, we are seeing what it is happening to the whole world. At least in India, we know the second waves are going to take a long, I mean, like, it's going to take a lot of pain for people, and it's going to again create the pressure that we have gone through last whole year. Now, do we really have to keep the social distancing to keep us away from our closed ones? Yes, of course, we have to do, but it not necessarily be away from them without being connected emotionally. We can't be. As a human, everyone has a desire and has a need for being so emotionally connected with people, though we are staying away. Of course, the technology that today we have is definitely helping us getting connected with them through the available WhatsApp or through the available social connects that we are having. But will this give the fullest of required support is a question that we have to ask. I would say yes, at least to, as Badri was asking, life or livelihood, it's giving us a livelihood to sustain, to at least serve the bread and butter is what I would say. So with that being said, we can't stay without the emotions. We have to be definitely connected with people with emotions. But yes, of course, the situations are pushing us to limit the amount of emotional connect that we are having, and we have to adhere at this pressing time. So over to you, Badri.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vidya. Emotional distancing, I think Meraki is bridging the gap with these sessions all.